confused about our own culture. I couldn't understand all the aggression that we have here, all the anger that we have here, that they didn't have over there even during the war. And when I returned over there, they were the same. They don't have the anger, they don't have the PTSD. The culture shock is coming back here, not going there.
Tommy, had you had thoughts about returning to Vietnam?
Not for many years, decades. People started going back, I think, in the 90s. Veterans started going back, and I thought about it. When I was over there in 67, I recognized it was a very beautiful place. You know, we might have considered it third world. I thought it was beautiful. I thought the people were very clean and industrious. And I didn't really think that it required a lot of change. I was taken by the beauty of it despite the circumstances. And in that sense, I always thought it would be a nice place to be a tourist in peace. But after people started going back, you know, you still have the anxiety and that fear. I couldn't really conceive of going back without being armed until I went to a workshop with Dr. Ed Pick, and he had a spiritual approach to recovery from these issues. And I had recognized from some of my hospital stays that the VA got the spiritual side of me, and probably others as well, wasn't being addressed at all. And I went looking for help in the hospital spiritually, even though I don't have a faith base on a particular religion. I recognized there was something lacking there. And it was basically almost 20 years before I found somebody to help me address that. And as soon as Dr. Pick talked about the soldier's heart, I stepped right up and I went back and haven't regretted a thing about it.
When you returned, how were you first received by the Vietnamese? What do you remember about that?
I perceived less about the Vietnamese than myself. It was healing in itself, just step down on the ground and not be afraid. And they are very gracious people.
Mm-hmm. Outside, what happened when you met Vietnamese vets for the first time on the return trip?
Well, there was always just a little bit of anxiety because the last thing you recall, the rockets still going off and people shooting. So we went back and we had just a... Intellectually, I was fine. But emotionally, the imprint was always there. When I stepped on the ground, I was able to see smiles and to see the graciousness of those people that I had experienced a long time before that. And in a sense, it felt like, yeah, I know these people. That's like family.
Tommy, I think it was you that said to me in a prior phone call that you found the Vietnamese more respectful of the Americans' situation than some in our country here in the States. How would you explain that?
I wish I could explain it. I just think it's part of the human condition to have a difficulty admitting even to oneself that they've been wrong about one thing or another. Maybe about our entrance into the war at all, or the aftermath, or how our culture has treated not just the returning veterans, but Vietnamese as well. You know, I finally accepted that I can't explain. I just accept it. Try to keep on surviving.
When you went on your trip, were you meeting with the Viet Cong vets, not the Vietnamese vets? What kinds of things did you talk about if you did meet with them?
Well, my first encounter was going down to Mekong Delta, to Tom Tien's place, and Tom Tien was a Viet Cong. He was the former enemy. He greeted us with a big smile and hugs. I mean, that's, you know, you kind of go, wow. And he wants to hear your story. He told us his story. We shot it, left him for dead. He was treated for like 9 months, as I remember, in the Fuchin tunnels over there. But he had no grudge. He really wanted to meet the person that shot him to say that he held no grudge. He forgave him. And when he came over to this country, it was the same. I felt like I had a very strong brother who came to visit me.
What do you think is so different about how the Vietnamese seem to heal from war and to give as compared to what you experienced for sitting in American life?
That was expressed all the time in our journey over there. Why? Why the difference? And basically, they fought for their homeland, they fought for their culture, they fought for their families, they fought for an ideal, they fought for a way of life. Everything that, again, the soul comes together to form the soul. The internal of, yes, this is truly who I am. And we were over there because it was a political war. It was an intellectual war. We didn't have a reason really to be there. And we were told to just go out. So our reason for being there, our sole reason for being there, was to survive. And they don't have PTSD because they were fighting from the heart. They were fighting from the soul. And they didn't have that conflict.
Coming off of, was there an activity that you participated in on your healing journey that was especially significant for you for your healing?
There was a couple of factors in there that were significant. First of all, the bonding with the fellow vets that were on the trip. Their understanding of what you went through while you were there the first time and what you've been going through in the past years. Thank you.